fuck everybody, nigga. Keep running, nigga. Run this shit up, nigga. Run this shit all the way up, nigga. Keep running, no motherfucking more, nigga. All the way up, nigga. Fuck off, nigga. To the motherfucking ceiling, nigga. Fuck these bitches. Fuck these niggas, too. Fuck them all. Yeah, I mean this shit. For real, nigga. Straight up. Hey. If I sacrifice myself, will I go to hell? In my trap, I'm counting wallets, talking to my scale. My jewelry box having more water.
E, what's up, man? How y'all been? We've been out of touch for a little, man. There's a lot of changes. My baby came off the road, but I'm still out here every day in everybody's state. We'll see you shortly. But anyway, man, was Young Dolph a sacrifice? Was my boy Young Dolph a sacrifice? Tell me, that's crazy. Like, I'm sitting here listening to the same song over and over and over and over again. Like, I'm out here like 11. Plus hours, so all I do is listen to music and watch movies. And, you know, I'm not gonna go here and get too deep and act like I'm a Lazarus Day Satan, something like that, to the point where I'm acting crazy. But I do know what I know. It's like, you know what you know and you don't know what you don't know. It's just that simple. I know what I know. I follow a lot of stuff. And I said to myself, and I told some of my friends, couple months back, I said, listen, Young Dolph, you know, everybody say he's an independent life artist, he's not an independent artist, he is signed, but they said Young Dolph was shot at his favorite cookie store. Now this says I'm playing the song I was playing, and it's the reason why I was playing it. In the beginning of the first verse, he said, if I sacrifice myself, will I go to hell? Listen, a couple months back, I was talking to some friends, and you see Young Dolph, he got the Empire distribution deal, and he came out with the album cover with a lot of Illuminati signs and stuff on it. In this particular video, he had a lot of the same resemblances. A lot of, from the gate intro to the outro, a lot of Illuminati resemblance with the eye and the money, but just a lot of resemblance. Like I said, just go watch the video. It's called Talking to My Scale. I played this song, if I drive 11 hours, 6 hours, throughout the course of the ride, you know, if I'd be on a song, I'd be on it, but it wasn't the actual song that I was on so much. Nah, it's fine. I ain't go hard, but it wasn't the actual song that had me locked. It was just all the symbols in it. And that first bar again, if I sacrifice myself, will I go to hell? I told to my friends back, I said, listen, if something happened to Young Dolph, they sacrificed him. That's the reason he was the album cover. You know, the same resemblances and the same signs as the video. That's the reason it was the album cover. Same with Mo3. RIP Mo3. Rest in peace, Roy Lee. 219. Rest in peace to the boy Mo3, same thing. They call Mo3 on the freeway. A lot of the same symbols. A lot of, if you listen to Mo3, I was a Mo3 fan from his first mixtape, rapping on Twista beats. You know, he still rap on everybody beat, but I was a legit Mo3 fan from the beginning. And like I said, I could have said something about Mo3 a while, but I ain't going to. Like I said, I don't really get into all that. But then it's like, now Dolph, I'm like, man, that's crazy. So a lot of the same resemblance from Mo3. And a lot of stuff he's talking about. Mo3 predicted his death like he was Pac. Like Pac said, this industry will turn your best friends into your enemies. Something like that. Should have been said. This industry will turn your best friends into your enemies. Young Dolph was shot outside his cookie store. His favorite cookie store, getting his mom's cookies. Handing out turkeys to Everybody who was giving it to his neighborhood, good. I'm sorry, I'm driving, y'all. These folks can't drive sometimes. I get to look at the road. But yeah, they, you know, Dolph is a good dude, man. You know, he, you know, just, you know, I've been following Dolph for over again. I don't ride to certain people, but just like, I'm either riding R&B or I'm riding a select few. Yeah, Dolph. Dolph was his own boss to the extent that he was signed to a label. He was signed to a label, you know. And like I said, when I told him, I talked to my friends from months back, I said, if something happened to Young Dolph, then that was a sacrifice. And they was like, bro, you crazy. You always talking that crazy shit. I'm like, all right. I was like, all right. Then I get a call. Bro, you heard what happened to Young Dolph? Man, I just don't think it's that many coincidences. And then again, let's go a little further. Empire, everybody that's been recently, I don't know, you know, I'm sure it's been going on forever, just like a lot of other things. But anybody that's been signed to Empire, get to with an Empire distribution deal, 03, again, Young Dolph, XXX. I know I'm missing something. But that's just to mention three. Speaking of three, Young Dolph died at 36. 9 means completion. 3 plus 6 equals 9. Thank you, So-So Madame, for helping me get my numbers right. Y'all know her, but watch So-So Madame. She, I'm sure she's gonna take you here down the rabbit hole. You know, she, I sit back and I listen to a lot of people. This stuff I've been doing, like, I've been on since I was little, you know. But I just don't get on here and try to just act like I know what's going on. I don't. But you know what you know, even when you don't know. And it's just like, I know what I know. Even if I'm wrong, I still know it's something. Dolph ain't just get hit, and this thing like, come on, 03 ain't just get hit. And boy ain't just get hit up. Think about it. Homo 3 talked about on his last album was pretty much him dying. He was talking to a speech with a spiritual reader. He said in this music, if he died, he had to be pretty much not word for word, but if he died, he had to be, he got so many, he had to how he died, you know, pretty much. You know, I got so many Mo 3 songs, you know, I can't even put one together off top just to rap it, because I've been rapping the whole shit. But you know, like I said, I was a real life Mo 3 fan. You know? Matter of fact, I think the song was, I thought I knew who you were. I thought I knew who you was. I thought I knew who I trust. Find out this shit, man, for real. I must be dumb as they come. Yeah, no. I mean, you think you're talking about a female, but you're not. I mean, sound good. You know, Mo 3 had a lot to it. Style was great, but ain't no coincidence. Let's go to XXX, since I brought him in. Empire distribution, you know, Empire distribution deal. Right? And he said, I know he said in one of his videos, if I died and killed myself, something like that down that avenue, I was sacrificed. Come on, man, King Von. Another. I'm thinking of this off the top. None of this is written now. It's really me riding down the road thinking. You know, it's still crazy. Man, I was going to speak on it last night, but I said to myself, man, I'm out here driving. I'm real like mad. You know, I'll tag Facebook. Everybody who know me know, you know, I'm a Dolph fan. You know, that's all I really ride to. Dolph 3, Key Glock, Meek Mill. Other artists, you know, but that's me, that's what I like to ride to. Outside of that, I'm pretty much R&B, you know, pretty much R&B. I mean, this is, I ain't gonna say that's all I ride to. That's a lot of few other artists I cut on to. Like I said, King Bones, one of them, you know, I like Shiesty, even though he's locked up. But that, you know, those ain't the topic of the conversation. The topic of the conversation is, is it street shit? Or is it a sacrifice? Think about it. Is it street shit or is it sacrifice? Is it all just a coincidence? And shit, and we can just chalk it up to that's life, shit just happens? Or is it deeper than rock? I sit back and like I said, I see a lot of crazy stuff. I mean, I don't even know what my mind be sometimes. Like, I just be, people, I say some shit, and I'm like, bro, what are you talking about? And that's fine. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And something like I said, if you know, you know. And it just don't, a lot of this shit just don't add up to it. I mean, come on, man, that man was sitting in a cookie store. I mean, tell me, some folks just jumped up out at him. Race with him, pants, black hoodie. You know, I waited to this morning because I wanted to really get more news on what really happened. Like, I seen live videos when it happened, but I'm like, damn, like, gotta be more to it. You know, it was a hit, bro. Like, it was too obvious. It was a hit. It was too perfect. I mean, you got, okay, you can wrap it up and say, yeah, they was following them for this amount of time. But they had to at some point know where you was at. Who was you around? Who was you talking to? What was your bodyguard that was there with you supposedly? And if it ain't no supposedly, he was there with you, where he at? Why he ain't over there laid out with you? Why he ain't sitting back telling what's going on? So what really going on? So you know, it's always more than meets the eye. And you know, like I said, I don't really sit back in, try to get too deep in. Talk, I just rather listen. I'm fine just gaining knowledge. I'm fine if, you know, all I do is progress in life. Money ain't everything. Knowledge, I'm not gonna sit here and say it don't matter. I'm out here, you know, running this business because it does matter. But at the end of the day, you know, money ain't everything. Life's about progress. Progress is about knowledge. As long as you progress forward, it don't really, you know, the rest of that don't really equate, don't add up. This shit ain't mad at all to you. This shit don't add up. Street shit or sacrifice. Chalk it up to life. Shit happens. But what a sacrifice. Like I said, man, these rappers know. These celebrities know. Dolph, I don't think about it. He said he was retiring. He said he was retiring. He didn't even let nobody know he was signed to a label. He just one day said, ha, yeah, y'all simply start hating on me now. Da da da, something around that avenue. You know, he didn't even know, you know, nobody, you know, he always said nobody liked him in the industry. You know, Dolph was on his, he was in his own lane, but, you know, everybody know you don't make it out of without giving somebody. But he played the role as I'm an independent artist and made bank from it. Strategy. People gonna say it was Yo Gotti, Black Young Slim. All right. Man, listen, Gotti already got his hands on them. He already got his hands on them. Don't worry about Dolph no more. That's done for. That was a whole other subject. People gonna say Soulja Boy. Soulja Boy had a different thing. I think they was beefing over Glock. You know, being your own boss, something like that. Soulja Boy wasn't going there. Y'all been folks Soulja Boy. Soulja Boy got into it with Chris. His beef with Chris Brown was beefing with it. So at the end of the day, man, Chris Brown still on stage. Acting like Chris Brown. God, somebody was calling. But, yeah. Soulja Boy, like I said, Soulja Boy and Chris Brown, beef was deeper than that. So, Chris Brown still don't say, same like Chris Brown. So, oh, man. Yeah, it ain't like me saying nothing about it. Don't change nothing. People want to think what they want to think. Numbers don't lie regardless of what you think. Always number related. All three number related. About XXX is number related. You know. BMX, whether it was or what, it was number related. Oh man. It's crazy. I'm a my favorite artists from him. They took one of my favorite artists from him. So I just wanted to speak on that just a little bit. And if I was, you know, a little all over the place, whatever, I'm just speaking from the top in traffic. So God don't be too hard on me in these comments. But all comments, you know, likes, dislikes, whatever, appreciate it. Love all y'all. Appreciate TG, baby.